Merry Christmas. Good morning and welcome to St. Michael's the Archangel's Catholic community on this Christmas morning. I got the wrong read here. Anyway. We especially send out a warm welcome to all who are here today and to all who are visiting. Now that we're having more people attend Mass during the weekends, we must remind everyone that masks must be left on in place, covering your nose and your mouth during the entire Mass. We have increased our cleaning schedule in both the church and after Masses because we want to continue to keep people safe. Please do your part in wearing your mask and washing your hands before being seated. Please remember to leave at least 3 seats between you and the next person who is not of your household. Thank you. Please remember to use your I think we've already done our Christmas flower. I must have the wrong reading, but I'm trying to do the anyway. I don't know if anybody still wants to get their envelopes there on the table in the back. And if you know anybody that's not physically able to attend Mass at this time and they're one of your neighbors, would you be sure and pick them up for them? We remember in our prayers Claire M. Dings, whose funeral Mass was recently, and for all parishioners of St. Michael's Parish, those living and deceased. Let us now pray the prayer of St. Michael for the men and women who served in our armed service. St. Michael the Archangel,
defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who wander through the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
At this moment, let us take a few moments to quiet our hearts and our minds in a period of sacred silence.
Our opening hymn this morning is O Come, O Ye Faithful. Please stand and greet our celebrant, our pastor, Father Legato.
O come, O ye faithful, joyful and triumphant, O come ye, O come ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Sing choirs of angels, sing in exaltation, sing all ye citizens of heaven above. Glory to God, all glory in the highest. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. A Deste Fidelis, Laeti Triumphantes, Venite, Venite in Bethlehem. Natum vitae, Regem Angelorum, Venite Adoremus, Venite Adoremus, Venite Adoremus.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Father.
We come to celebrate the Nativity of our Lord Jesus Christ, the incarnation of our Savior, born into the world, the Word becoming flesh itself. When divinity touched humanity and heaven and earth were joined together in this great moment of salvation and redemption. Turning to our Lord Jesus Christ in thanksgiving for this great gift of forgiveness of sin and new life, which is promised in the Nativity of our Lord, we ask for pardon and peace.
Child Jesus, Son of God, you are born among us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Child Jesus, Son of Mary, you free us from sin and death. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Child Jesus, you nourish us for the journey to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us, for you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who wonderfully created the dignity of human nature, and still more wonderfully restored it, grant, we pray, that we may share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. How beautiful upon the mountains are the feet of him who brings glad tidings, announcing peace, bearing good news, announcing salvation, and saying to Zion, your God is king. Hark, your sentinels raise a cry. Together they shout joy, for they see directly before their eyes the Lord restoring Zion. Break out together in song, O ruins of Jerusalem. For the Lord comforts his people. He redeems Jerusalem. The Lord has bared his holy arm in the sight of all the nations. All the ends of the earth will behold the salvation of our God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
All the ends of the earth have seen the saving power of God. All the ends of the earth have seen the saving power to the Lord a new song, for he has done wondrous deeds. His right hand has won victory for him, his holy arm. All the ends of the earth have seen the saving power of God. The Lord has made his salvation known. In the sight of the nations, he has revealed his justice. He has remembered his kindness and his faithfulness toward the house of Israel. All the ends of the earth have seen the saving power of the earth have seen the salvation by our God. Sing joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Break into song, sing praise. All the ends of the earth have seen the saving power of God. Sing praise to the Lord with the harp and melodious song. With trumpets and the sound of the horn,
Sing joyfully before the King, the Lord. All the ends of the earth have seen the saving power of God.
A reading from the beginning of the letter of to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, in times past, God spoke in partial and various ways to our ancestors through the prophets. In these last days, he has spoken to us through the Son, whom he made heir to all things, of all things, and through whom he created the universe, who is the refulgence of his glory, the very imprint of his being, and who remains all things by his mighty word. When he has accomplished purification from sins, he took his seat at the right hand of the majesty on high, as far superior to the angels, as the name he has inherited is more excellent than theirs. For to which of the angels did God ever say, "You are my son, this day I have begotten you"? Or again, "I will be a father to him, and he shall be a son to me"? And again, when he leads the firstborn into the world, he says, "Let all the angels of God worship him." The word of the Lord.
Thanks
be to God.
From the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that the whole world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment when Quirinius was governor of Syria. So all went to be enrolled, each to his own town. And Joseph, too, went up from Galilee to the town of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David, that is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. While they were there, the time came for her to have her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them at the inn. Now there were shepherds in that region living in the fields and keeping the night watch over their flock. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were struck with great fear. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I proclaim to you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For today in the city of David, a Savior has been born for you, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find an infant wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was a multitude of heavenly hosts with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those whom his favor rests." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
And a decree went out from Augustus Caesar that all the world should be enrolled. And so Joseph took Mary from Nazareth to the city of David called Bethlehem for them to be enrolled with all the world. We have much in common today with what Joseph and Mary themselves experienced when they had to comply with that enrollment, that census that Augustus Caesar had decreed. We have lived through these many long months with that same experience, with executive orders, with guidelines and protocols, not only for ourselves and our nation, but the entire world has experienced that same type of call that Mary and Joseph themselves had to respond to. And we think that it is difficult for us on a daily basis to comply with those protocols and guidelines. Let's put ourselves in the place of Mary, who, when probably finding out from Joseph that she who was 9 months pregnant had to ride a donkey from Nazareth to Bethlehem. I can't imagine she was too thrilled about having to do that. But Mary and Joseph knew what they had to do, and they did it, not knowing or realizing the difficulties that they were going to encounter. They entrusted themselves to the Lord, that the Lord would help them on the journey, the Lord would get them there safely, and the Lord would keep them there safely and return them home. We ourselves are called to trust in the Lord in that very same way in our own lives today, knowing that the Lord will provide for us what we need when we need it. So Mary and Joseph needed to have a place to rest their heads, and there was no place to be found. And they end up in a stable with the animals, and Mary gives birth to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And they lay him in a manger. This, I am sure, was not the way that Mary wanted this to occur, but it is the way that God, our Heavenly Father, wanted it to occur, because it reveals to us who Jesus Christ is, why he has come into the world, and what he will do for us. All of that is seen in the Nativity. Our entire salvation is depicted in the Nativity itself. And so just as Mary and Joseph had to deal with the circumstances that they were presented with, we have found ourselves having to do the very same thing. All of the traditions that normally we would experience during the Christmas season have all been affected. They've all changed to one extent or another. We ourselves had to learn how to go Christmas shopping in a very different way if we were not used to going shopping online. No longer could we join in the multitudes of crowds at the stores and the malls, shoulder to shoulder, looking for that special perfect gift or any gift just to get the shopping done. No longer could we just plan our Christmas parties, having our friends over, having our coworkers join us in parties. And even our families have had to decide how we were going to get together for Christmas safely. Our children could not sing in their school Christmas concerts, and we could not go to hear them either. Our own choirs are not able to even get together because they can't stand that close together to sing. We can't even see the smiling faces when we say Merry Christmas to one another because we all have masks on. Everything that we ourselves have known about this season have been stripped away. And what we are left with is what should have always been central in our lives in the celebration of Christmas. We are left with the Nativity of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And all these many months, the journey that we ourselves have experienced is much like that journey that Mary and Joseph themselves experienced going from Nazareth to Bethlehem, because it was preparing us for this moment to celebrate the Nativity of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and to celebrate it joyfully. Remember back in March when that executive order came out, and on March 22nd on a Sunday evening at 10 p.m., the entire state closed down, and the nation closed down, and the world closed down, and we all had stay-at-home orders, and we wondered how we were going to get through it, and what we were getting through was Lent itself, for we were entering into the third week of Lent, and all of a sudden, Lent became a greater spiritual experience for most of us than it probably ever had been. All of a sudden, we started realizing what those disciplines of Lent were about, of prayer, of fasting, of almsgiving. Never before was prayer so essential for our daily lives, even though it was always essential. But we came to realize it. Never before did we understand how fasting and joining with the sufferings of the cross itself could help unite us and strengthen us and get us through all of that. Never before were we called to give so much of ourselves as an alms, and we were willing to do that for one another, for the health and safety of everybody. And so as Lent was entering into Holy Week and we still could not come together for the celebration of the most holiest time of the year for us as Christian people, we found ways for ourselves to be able to worship together as a community of faith. And the live streaming kept us bonded together And we came to know and understand a new term called spiritual communion. Because even though we could not receive the body and blood of Christ, we needed to know that the Lord was with us. And that spiritual communion became a source of strength and nourishment to each and every one of us as people of faith. And as the Easter season concluded and we entered into those solemnities and feasts of those first weeks of ordinary time in early June, in that second week of June, the good news came that we could gather together for Mass in person, and our doors were flung open, and we were joyful because that second Sunday of June was the solemnity and feast of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. And we realized never again do we want to be separated from the Eucharist. We came to know and understand more profoundly that the Eucharist is the source and summit of our lives, and without it, we struggle. Because we need to receive the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We see that in the Nativity. And as we just concluded Advent in preparation for Christmas, we've realized that Advent is not simply a preparation to celebrate a secular Christmas. Never before did we realize that preparation was meaning that we are being prepared. And what we are being prepared for is the coming of our Lord and Savior in any moment of our lives, because we know right now the Lord can come at any moment for any one of us. And so we are not struck with fear, rather we are filled with expectation and anticipation, as the Advent season calls us to be. And so it draws us to the Nativity. It draws us to when Christ first came into the world at his birth. And it helps us to understand how it prepares us for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ in the fullness of his glory, in any moment for each of us, and when he comes for all of us. Because it is in the Nativity that we see how our Lord in Jesus Christ provides for us. After all, Mary laid him in a manger. A manger. You know what a manger is. It's a feeding trough for animals. And so that manger that our Savior Jesus Christ lays in is a foreshadowing of how he himself will sustain us, nourish us, and strengthen us in our lives. That the Lord who lays in a manger is the Lord who provides for us at this altar his body and blood. So we have much to be thankful for. We are like those shepherds out in the field who were cold and afraid, and the angel of the Lord appeared to those shepherds and said, "I bring you great tidings of glad joy, of good news. For today, in the city of David, a Savior has been born. And you will find him wrapped in swaddling clothes, laid in a manger." We are those shepherds. We are reminded not to be afraid. We ourselves are reminded that we should be filled with glad tidings of great joy, for the good news has been given to us in the person of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And you may ask, well, why should I be rejoicing and glad in these terrible, difficult times? We have a vaccine. We're together here celebrating the Eucharist. We will receive the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. And we know by the celebration of Christmas that our Lord is always with us. Let us join together in the profession of our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things are made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism and forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Christ, our Savior, has been born on this holy day, and our God has made his presence known in our Lord Jesus Christ. So with steadfast faith, we place our hopes and needs before the Christ child.
For the church throughout the world, that we will forever bring the light of Christ into the world's darkness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace throughout the world, that the peace proclaimed by the angels to the shepherds will come to rest on all peoples of the earth, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an outpouring of God's graces this Christmas, for an end to disease and fear, and a new beginning, for a rekindling of a childlike spirit of wonder and awe, and for an excitement about life each day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are away from home and family this Christmas, for essential workers and those serving in the military, that God will preserve them in love and return them home safely, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the elderly and vulnerable, who are isolated this Christmas, that God will soon free them from their loneliness and reunite them with loved ones. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the poor, the homeless, the sick, and the unemployed, that the coming of Christ may bring hope, healing, and new opportunities for them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all parishioners of St. Michael's Parish, living and deceased, who we keep in our hearts, that they will share in the glory of the Lord forever. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Holy God, on this day the Word became flesh, and humanity and divinity were joined together in the incarnation. In the love that you have shown us and in the mercy and care that you have given us in your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, may that love itself manifest in our own hearts, so that we ourselves may always be a witness and a presence to that gift of our Savior to the world. We ask this as all things through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As you know, normally we would take up the collection at this time, but during these extraordinary times we are not able to do so. If you have not yet already left your envelope in the basket, you can do so on your way out at the exit. Or you can continue to mail in your envelopes, as so many have done, to the parish offices. Or you can sign up for electronic giving by simply going to the parish websites and downloading the electronic giving form and sending it into the office. Or call us at the office and we will fill it out for you over the phone. Or you can give right now immediately by clicking on the giving button on the parish websites or on the parish app, and you can give immediately and safely. Whatever way you give, we greatly appreciate your Christmas gift to the parishes, for it allows us to continue on Christ's mission and ministry. Merry Christmas.
Please join in our preparation hymn, Angels We Have Heard on High.
Angels we have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plains and the mountains in reply, echo back their joyous strains.
Accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Make acceptable, O Lord, our oblation on this solemn day, when you manifested the reconciliation that makes us wholly pleasing in your sight, and inaugurated for us the fullness of divine worship through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal, eternal God. For in the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize him God made visible, we are caught up through him in love of things invisible. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy. Highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, especially all the living and deceased parishioners of St. Michael the Archangel Church. And all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you, for them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, for they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating that most sacred day on which Blessed Mary, the Immaculate Virgin, brought forth the Savior for the world, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious and ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sextus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Prosagonus, John and Paul, Cosmos and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted amongst the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hand, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed passion, resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercy, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace.
Peace be with you.
Everybody. Peace. Peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my roof.
But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Once in royal David's city stood a lowly cattle shed, where a mother laid her baby in a manger for his bed. Mary was that mother mild. She
down to earth from heaven. Who is God and Lord of all? And his shelter was the stable, and his cradle was a stall. With the poor and mean and lowly lived on earth our Savior holy. O holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, oh, voices, oh, night divine, oh, night when Christ was born, oh, night divine, oh, night, oh, night divine.
Let us pray. Grant, O merciful God, that just as the Savior of the world born this day is the author of divine generation for us, so he may be the giver of even of immortality, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
On behalf of Father Zach Chichester, Father Mackey, Deacon Bob Sweeney, Deacon Nick Ashodi, and Deacon Warren Safford, and our staffs here at St. Michael's and St. Jude's, we want to wish you all a very blessed and merry Christmas.
Same to you, Father.
Thank you. Bow down for the blessing. May the God of infinite goodness, who by the incarnation of his Son has driven darkness from the world, and by that glorious birth has illuminated this most holy day, drive far from you the darkness of vice and illumine your hearts with the light of virtue.
Amen.
May God, who willed that the great joy of his son's saving birth be announced to shepherds by the angels, fill your minds with the gladness of that he gives and make you heralds of his gospel.
Amen.
And may God, who by the incarnation brought together the earthly and the heavenly realm, fill you with the gift of his peace and favor and make you sharers with the church in heaven.
Amen.
And may the blessings of Almighty God, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. And please join in our closing carol, Hark the Herald Angels Sing. Hark a herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King, peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies with angelic hosts proclaim. Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King.